Glory to God, glory to God.
Yes, God, yes, God. Come on, come on, come on.
Now work with me, work with me. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank
you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Ain't nobody up in here by accident. If you up in here, you up in here because God meant for you to be here. And you got a divine appointment with the Most High God. But I know Pastor Cynthia well, that's what I call her. I know Pastor Cynthia well enough to know that she ain't up here entertaining nobody. She trains her people.
Yes, Lord.
To walk in the way of the Lord. So get stirred up. Stay stirred up. Because God got something for you.
Yes, Lord.
And every, I want you to hear me say every assignment that the devil thought he had on your life.
Yes, Lord.
And with anybody who's connected to you.
Yes.
We come into agreement right now. And we cancel it in the name of Jesus. Don't look at things from the outside. Because God looks on the inside. And it is canceled in the mighty name of Jesus. Not because I said so, but because he said so. Not because I'm an apostle, but because he is the Most High God. And because he got something he wants you to do. I don't care who you think you were. God created you with a purpose. And he got something that he wants you to do. And being in this place at this time is part of your preparation to be able to walk into your destiny. The grace, unmerited favor, enablement, divine enablement that you're going to receive up in here is going to make it easier to do what you got to do. If you're going to do something for God, it ain't always easy. Matter of fact, most of the time it ain't. But we're going to do things differently than folks used to do. When we work for the Lord, we're going to enjoy our work. And he is going to be our passion the way we are his passion. So get stirred up and stay stirred up.
Amen.
Just praise him like you done lost your mind. When that cigarette speaks, she'll come up in here and she'll take the mic and she'll start speaking. But until she does, praise him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We surrender, Lord. He left me with the word of the Son. We surrender. Spirit, soul, and body. We surrender, God. We lay it all down right now. Don't even matter what it is. We lay it down. Anybody we need to forgive, huh? Now's a good time to do it. Just let it go, let it go, let it go. Not for them, but for you. You ain't got to tell nobody but Jesus. But let it go right now. Don't let no unforgiveness stand in the way of your blessing. Order about, get it straight right now. Before we even get started. Just pray in the spirit and release it. Let them go. Order about, forgive. And don't forget, if we don't forgive them, God don't forgive us.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
Forgive them. I don't care how long it's been. Forgive them. No matter what they did, it could be real bad, but forgive them. Or Rabba Shata Kiyapa. Jesus forgave the very people that chose him over a thief to be crucified. Oh, Rabba Shata Kiyapa. He didn't sin. He was without sin. He was carrying our sin. And he said, Father, forgive him. Oh, Rabba Shande Kiyapa. Because they know not what they do. Hallelujah. Forgive them, forgive them. And just so y'all know, God tells his prophets things. And he tells his apostles things. So whoever it is up in here who's still holding some unforgiveness, now's the time for you to let it go. I don't know who it is. I ain't trying to find out who it is. I'm just trying to get you to let it go so you won't miss your blessing. Praise you, God. Hallelujah. He's a life-changing God. He's a life-giving God. You want something different in your life, he'll give it to you. He let him to Korobosha. He shot Takiyapakaya. Them prayers you've been praying, do you really want God to answer them? Do you really, really, really want God to answer them? He let him to Korobosha. Do what it takes, forgive him. Forgive them. Oh, Rabbi Shatakiyapa.